So in a moment, I'd like to welcome up on stage some students from the Severi Correnti High School here in Milan. They've participated for the last 2 days in this forum with their teachers. They've been listening, they've been writing. They've got a letter now which they've written to world leaders. So I want you to concentrate on what they're going to say and also take in the images, not thankfully of me, but of world leaders on the big screen, which will come up as they give their presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, the students from Severi Correnti High School.
To government heads, to the heads of state, to the decision makers in emerging countries and established countries, to everybody who has a government responsibility, whatever their latitude and longitude in our planet where they are located. As citizens and future generations of the third millennium, we are powerless and still watch the great global paradoxes and the contradictions and injustices in our social organizations. Instead of finding answers or solutions, these emergencies are becoming larger and larger by the day, in total indifference of the old greats, of our fathers, of you adults who will soon hand over to our generation the responsibility to manage the world. Wealth and poverty are unequally distributed between populations, among populations. The lack of water and food in some countries is juxtaposed to excess and waste in other countries. Millions of children in our world, even today, have no access to food. They don't sit down for dinner each night, whereas 1 billion people are obese today. 80% of the global production of food is consumed by 20% of the global population. Every day, 5,000 people die because they have no access to water. Water and cereals are denied to our fellow people, but not to the 3 billion cattle that we're not sure we need for food, for feeding ourselves. Requires us to grow awareness and to open our eyes on these ethical and moral themes. We can't postpone that. What we heard in this room prompts us to ask for concrete actions to help people's well-being throughout the planet. Each and every one of us is called upon to give our support to these large challenges. We're actually talking to the leaders, to the greats of the earth, to our fathers, for you to put feeding and food and nutrition back in the heart of our agendas by putting together the necessary plans and by considering the necessary relationships between people and country for you to live as a more sustainable and equal and equitable planet. It is important for businesses and science to give their help to promote education and training programs to improve people's well-being. It is necessary for businesses to adopt more sustainable models to operate on global markets because facing the destiny and the future and requires us to share our commitment. Give us, the future generations, the opportunity to live a dignified life, just like the generations before us did. Start today, start here to build our future together, ours and those of the children who are yet to be born, because knowing the truth is the best way to start changing.